problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically.
If you're getting into black and white photography, you don't need to be mixing up all your own custom chemicals. You can buy prepackaged developer, fixer, hypoclear, and stop bathing, down the road you go. But I'm trying to get back to where I was when I left photography in the darkroom about almost 30 years ago. And I want to see what today's papers do with the chemistry that I was using back then. So I'm mixing up my own paper developer and my own fixer. I'm using pretty much standard stop bath and hypoclear, but the developer is a 54D formula, an old DuPont paper developer, and the fixer is F24, a metabisulfite fix that I just like the way it works with the paper. So I'll show you what's involved in mixing this stuff up, but just know that you can just buy prepackaged stuff and dump it in 125 degree hot water and stir it up, and you'll have the same kind of thing. But here's what I do. So I'm gonna mix up some fixer. Here's some sodium thiosulfate, hypocrystals, potassium metabisulfite. That's the cool part of this fix. And all this stuff from the formulary, I just can't say enough good stuff about the photographer's formulary for the chemical supplier. Everything is sealed up good. Tape, not just tape, but good tape. Just never have a problem with their stuff. Look at this tape. Scale, I use just a plain piece of paper on the scale to put the chemicals on. So for larger quantities, sometimes a folded up piece of paper may not be enough on the scale. You just improvise. I was looking around. Here's an old set of Cibachrome filters. There's the top of that box. So you just put it on your scale. Of course, the scale will weigh it, but then you hit the tear button and that zeroes the scale weight. So the scale's got zero weight with that empty plastic tray on it. Now you put your chemicals in there, get your weight. I still like a piece of paper underneath the chemicals, so I re-zero the scale out, and now let me load it up. So I'm using a silver spoon to scoop out potassium metabisulfite, get 125 grams of it, and next I'll need 50 grams of sodium sulfite. 50 grams of sodium sulfite. And that's what I need to make my fixer. When it comes time to pour the chemicals out, I just fold up a little V funnel on it. I will mix. This is good. So I'm just crushing up the hypo, mixing it up. Stick your hands in the water, get the feel of 100 degrees. Mix in the metabisulfite, mix in the sodium sulfite, I like this big bucket because you can see down in the bottom, here's a couple of pieces of metabisulfite that haven't dissolved, and chop them up and swirl them around. Key now is this needs to sit overnight and cool off. This stuff is best below 68 degrees. Okay, so the fixer is mixed, and I like this metabisulfite fix. This is a non-hardening fix, so it's really good for paper. It makes it easier to retouch the paper, and it gives it a little bit of a greenish kind of tone that it's real subtle, but I like the way the metabisulfite fix works. You could use this fix to fix film. Most of the film has hardener in the film itself, so it's not as if it's the old style film where you needed a hardener for film, but people still like rapid fix with the hardener for film and this metabisulfite for paper. Move on from paper developer, and I'm using this 54D formula. It's a DuPont formula. If you look at all of these developer formulas, they're basically just different quantities of the same ingredients. Some of them, like Amidol, are completely different, but most of the paper developers you see are very similar and subtle takeoffs from one to the other. I like the way this 54D came out with the old gallery paper. I'm not sure if I'm gonna like the way this looks with the new Ilford multi-grade fiber-based paper. So here are your standard paper developers, and you see they're all using metol sodium sulfite, hydroquinone, sodium carbonate, and a little potassium bromide. It's just the ratio of different ingredients one to the other. And in all of these formulas, as the ingredients are given, that's the order that you mix them in. Important fact. So here we are, the makings of a gallon of 54D developer. Metol, hydroquinone, sodium sulfite, sodium carbonate, 10% potassium bromide solution. All we need is some hot water and my stirrer. So now your developer is mixed. Doesn't matter whether you're using Dectol or mixing up 54D or some other fancy trick developer. Trays are laid out, chemistry is ready, and you're almost ready to make some prints. But there's one more thing to think about. Gotta think about cross-contamination. Moving fixer backwards into the developer, moving hypoclear into the fixer. You just wanna rinse your hands, rinse your utensils, rinse everything between steps. I keep this old film developing tray handy. I keep water in it. And I'm always like if I'm in the fixer, I'm coming out and I'm rinsing my hands off in water. I may even be turning on the fresh water and running my hands under that, depending on what's what. You want to be careful you're not like dripping water backwards into the fix. You want to make sure that you're not spilling stuff when you're replenishing. Always rinsing off, rinsing your hands, rinsing your utensils. Here's my stirrer. It's rinsed and it's in a beaker. And after that dries, I'll probably rinse the beaker because there may be some little residue that gathered in the beaker. You just can't be careful enough, rinse enough. And then, of course, make sure your hands are not only rinsed, but dry when you go over to the paper safe and you start handling paper. The last thing you want is to see your fingerprints on your prints. Also notice the quick connect for the hose, so I can be hosing off the sink if I want, and then I've still got access to the hose neck, to the gooseneck. Here are a couple of other paper developer formulas. It's a metol hydroquinone. This one is long tonal response. Brilliant rich blacks. Here's the old Beers 2 solution. You get back so you can see them both. And just stop the video to copy these. Here's Brett Weston's Amidol formula. glycine developer. And then the bottom, this is 54D, my note, this is the one. I used to like this developer. And then of course you can be mixing Selectol Soft and Dectol. That D72 is Dectol. You can be mixing those developers together to work on shadows and highlights both. Okay, let me get that dirty developer tray cleaned up and refresh some of the other chemistry here. And next video, we'll be ready to make a print.
The problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically. I'd like to help you in your struggle to be.